Hey guys, this is Hellhate, it's free to play. Guys, I really want to do a video here where I just showcase how anyone who plays this game can get themselves to Nightmare Clan Boss within a couple of months. And it's about how you focus the right type of champions to get there. This is my new personal best on the free to play. Just hit it today, just now. Nightmare Clan Boss. I'm literally 2 months into the game, basically right now. Okay, this is not the best clan boss team that I could produce with champions in this game. It's literally just using the things that fell to me as a free-to-play player along the last couple of months. And what I want to do is just talk about how anyone can do it, the type of things you need to look for, the type of ways you need to do damage, the type of ways you need to stay alive, etc. So we're going to run through that in this video. And just to give you a quick visual on daily login. So I'm 62 days in, so I'm like a day over 2 months, and we're basically in a position where I'm comfortably 3-keying Nightmare Clan Boss, but potentially 2-keying. And why is that important? Well, a couple of reasons. So with Clan Boss, if you can do, generally you're going to get 4 keys in a day if you play the game actively and don't mind staying up a bit late and hitting the Clan Boss key a bit early, right? So generally 4 keys in a day, they reset every 6 hours. So, you know, feasibly, you can use 4. So if you can get to the point where you are 3-keying Nightmare Clan Boss, so getting over 39 million damage with 3 keys, that same team should be able to 1-key Brutal, which means you're going to get, providing you're in a clan that kills it, you're going to get a double chest from Nightmare. And this is where you start to get shards and books. Yeah, Nightmare is where it's at. And you're also going to get a double chest from Brutal, but providing your clan are killing both of those things, where, again, you've got a chance to get a couple of goodies if you are more fortunate. Brutal's harder to get good stuff. But Nightmare's where it really starts to change for your account, and you need to get to Nightmare Clan Boss as soon as you can. You really do. Like, if you want to play this game long-term and get some cool champs and that sort of stuff, Nightmare's where it starts to change your account, because you get enough rewards from this that you are able to compete in fusions. You are able to just enjoy the game more. That's literally it. You will enjoy the game more because you will get more resources. So let's go through some of the fundamentals then of what you need. Firstly, you need a team of 6-star champions. I don't want to teach people to suck eggs too much, but you need 6-star champions, okay? You need 5 of them, and they all need to have some sort of relevance to a clan boss team. Always focus on clan boss champions first on a new account. Okay, they're just the ones that I want a 6-star because they make such a difference. So 6-star champions, and you need 5 of them. Okay, that's the basics. After that, you need to make sure that one of them has got a skill that consistently puts out decreased attack. You'll notice that this champion is fully booked because I want this decreased attack to have the best possible chance to land as I can. Okay, it's really important. Decreased attack basically reduces the amount of damage you've got coming into you, therefore you live longer. It's pretty basic, but the more this is on, the better. And for someone like this who's got a decreased attack on the A1 main skill or basic skill, I also add an improved chance to get that decreased attack on because it's such an important skill. And I put Master Hexer on, which gives me a chance to extend it for another turn. Therefore, it's just up more consistently. You'll also notice that everyone that I've got masteries for has got War Master or Giant Slayer. This is insane for 2 reasons. Firstly, it gives you a good amount of damage. Secondly, it gives you a ton of healing. And actually, the healing is the more important part. I can do damage in other ways, but I have to stay alive. And you'll see in a run, when I show a run, I've got one champion that does not have War Master yet, and that is the champion that is always dead first. Okay, so War Master really important. So you see here, I've got War Master, and then that needs to be then paired with Life Steal Gear. Or you need to put Leech on the Clan Boss so that when you hit and get your War Master hit, which is a big hit, it heals you back to full. Okay, and then you can keep going. So some form of healing for every single person that's in your run is really important. And some form of mastery. So one of my team right now does not have masteries. This will be the person that is dead first. She also does not have lifesteal gear. So again, she will be dead first because of that. Whereas everybody else, lifesteal gear, Warmaster. Warmaster, lifesteal. Lifesteal, Warmaster. Warmaster, lifesteal. You see, it's not by chance that they've got these things on. It's because I need that to stay alive for long enough to do the sort of damage that I need to do. The next thing is starting to think about team composition. So I would love an ally protection champion. Ally protection champion would make my run right now way easier, honestly. And there's a few very good epics that you can get that do this. Taradia the Frog will do it. You've got someone like a Skull Crusher will do it. You're basically looking for someone that does ally protection buff on all allies and the big version, 50%. You just come down the right-hand side of hellhades.com. You can literally come down and just be like, okay, well, who puts up the buff ally protection? Yeah, and you can just scroll down and be like, well, which of these do I have? Jared, really good one. Does the decreased attack and ally protection. Kenichi, a good one. Rearguard Sergeant, a good one. These are all great, like, entry-level epics. Trumbar, really good one. Yeah, so anyway, you want to be finding champions in your team that have got this skill if you can, because they will keep your team alive for a while. In a funky type of way, I'm just stopping there because this video is sponsored by me or sponsored by Fateless. It's not sponsored. I just want to let you know that we've put out a couple of really cool update videos on Fateless. So Fateless, for those who don't know, I'm creating a game like Raid Shadow Legends in terms of RPG, turn-based, and Fateless as a crew, we are creating this awesome game. I put out two videos recently, creating a legendary and this one here, Just Wow. It's showing some of the champions that we're actually creating right now. It's happening right now. And it's showing some of the behind the scenes of how it works. You should check out these two videos. Like, they are actually brilliant if you want to understand some of the behind the scenes of how producing a game happens. The actual artists doing their work, all this type of stuff is there. So you should definitely go and check that out. Anyway, I digress. I was on YouTube and I was like, you know what? I should definitely call that out because they were two really good videos. Anyway, so we've got decreased attack. We've got a way to heal. Ally protection is a great addition if you can fit it in. And then we just need to stay alive and do damage, right? So it's pretty simple. Warmaster is a good way of doing damage. Poison is a good way of doing damage. So there's a bunch of champions that do it really well. Juliana is a mid-tier one, but she puts out a lot of damage and she doesn't need books. That's all good for me. You've got someone like Occult Brawler, really good. Kayle is not bad as your starter hero. Frozen Banshee is good. There's a whole load of champions now that will just do a lot of poison damage. And that's your entry-level damage into Clan Boss. Most of us right now will also have a Rathalos, maybe a Blessing on him. If you can put Brimstone on him as well, then great. That's a load of additional damage. And Rathalos does hit like an absolute freaking beast. I'm going to re-gear mine before long, but even in this average gear, 4.5k attack, nearly crit capped, 172% crit damage, he absolutely ruins the Clan Boss. Yeah, so that works pretty well. Now, a couple of things which I am not yet achieving, but I'm getting away with it, is I don't have enough accuracy in my builds, but I'm just about sneakily getting away with it. Like, see here, 123, it's not enough. He's not in the team anymore. 148, it's short. 142, it's short. I should be really at least 170 accuracy to like consistently land my abilities. And it's an issue. It is an issue, right? If you don't land your abilities, you're going to get caught out. There'll be times where if you did land that ability, you would just stay alive for longer. For example, me not landing my decreased attack means that I've got a reasonable chance to mess up a run. A reasonable chance. So far, it's been working okay, honestly, at this accuracy. But still, that's going to be one of the things that lets me down. And things like accuracy banners really help with that. So that's kind of like next on the list. But it's one of the things which you definitely need to pay attention to. Anyone who's landing debuffs for you, i.e. poisoners, burners, decreased attack champions, decreased defense champions, they all need accuracy to do that job. Okay, and it's a really important thing. Another thing you will notice with my team is that everybody is over 170 speed. Yeah, it's just like plain and simple. The more times you hit that clan boss, the more damage you're going to do, more times you're going to land your abilities, etc. So I'm in currently a really basic version of my builds. I'm not speed tuned for clan boss in any way, but I'm still doing good damage because I've got the basics close to perfect. Like basic speed in a good place. I'm just about scraping the accuracy. Everyone's going to heal when they do their hits. I've got masteries in the bag. And then I'm just throwing people in the mix. Okay, I've got someone who's going to give me a bit of shieldage to keep me alive for longer. Because of these things, I'm able to just stay alive and hit the clan boss for a decent level of damage. And at that point, you're then, as I say, two or three keying Nightmare Clan Boss. And this is where, you, as I say, you start to get some good rewards. Brimstone here. In terms of blessings for your clan boss team, Brimstone, you absolutely want it on one of your legendaries. It does a lot of damage. Bringing someone in with cruelty is not a bad thing in terms of just making everybody do a little bit more damage. The cruelty reduces the defense of the clan boss. Higher level blessing would be great, but I've only got a level one, whatever. Anyone else really, like rares always bring Phantom Touch. It's a bit of extra damage. Same with an attack-based kind of like damage dealer. If I had another blessing here, I would either just go Brimstone again to double up, or I would take something like an enhancement to my aura. Anyway, yeah, so let's play this through and you can see the team in action. But yeah, 2 months in, very basic team. We're applying as many poisons as we can. We've got Rathalos throwing the smites out. We've got drop defense in the team. Burns going out from my jewels and big old smacks coming in from Rathalos. And then I'm hoping for decreased attack as often as possible from my decreased attack champion, which for me is Sepulchre Sentinel. I haven't made sure that, you know, we speed tune it in the right way so that my stuns don't land on me and stuff. Mainly because actually I want the increased defense up just as often as possible. I could speed tune this team to be more effective. I can, and I will eventually. I wanted to show here, because a lot of people say, oh yeah, but you know, it's so hard to do what you do. And this video is more about the fact that it's not if you get all of the basics in a good place. The speed tuning and stuff enhances the team. I could probably guarantee myself 25 to 30 mil if I did like a proper speed tune. I redid everyone, which I will do at some point, probably in the next few weeks, okay? But I think that comes really when I'm absolutely pushing for Ultra Nightmare Clan Boss. An Ultra Nightmare Clan Boss is a massive step up in difficulty. And you do need more consistently landing things like your decreased attack. You need to get things like your stun blocking in the right place. And you need to last a lot longer to get the level of damage that you need to do in Ultra Nightmare Clan Boss. So anyway, I'll let this play through. You can watch it through to the end. And yeah, then we'll wrap up. So here we go. I will say, actually, I'm just going to pause for a second. This is a fine run. It's okay. It's around the sort of level of damage numbers expected. My 20 mil was my best run that I've done so far. If I'm not happy with this run right now, I can close the game down and not lose my key. If I end battle, I lose my key and I can't try again. If I feel like I've just got particularly bad RNG, or I feel like I've made a mistake or whatever, then I can close the game completely and I will rerun it and use and not lose my key. But for me, this is about the level of damage I'm expecting. As I say, the 20 mil was an exceptional good run, but still comfortable 3 key. That's what I'm after, comfortable 3 key. So I can then go and 1 key brutal and move on with my life. 6 mil damage from the Blade Master, nearly 6 mil, well, 5.5 mil from Juliana. Considerably more than Kale. Kale's the next person that I drop from this team, believe it or not. Like he's been a staple right the way through the account. At this point, you start to find better alternatives, and he gets redeployed as a specialist in something, whether it's your specialist campaign farmer, arena nuker, or whatever, like whatever you want it to be. But he comes into a different role when you get to this sort of place. So if I get an ally protection champion, like the ones I spoke about earlier, Kale comes out, swaps with the ally protector, and then this is probably moving on to Ultra Nightmare. That's the difference ally protection makes. Yeah, so look, that's going to be it for this video. Hope you learned something new there, and I hope you realize how comfortable you can be to move to Nightmare Clan Boss. Anyway, I've been Hell Hades, free to play. I'll see you soon.